What made my isolation in Barcelona bearable was work for his mocha.
The Illinois High-Speed Motor Corporation.
Like nearly everyone else, I had seen Arthur Miller's play, and as a youth had the usual sneering, deprecating attitude to the world of business and sales. All that changed senior year when the charismatic professor Woodward Thompson's business course convinced us that even the apparently mundane world of business had its romance. A job interview with his MOCO had led to employment in his training program. We were supposed to rotate between departments, but I arrived in sales just as a flu epidemic struck and never left. In sales, I found not just a job, but a culture. Franklin, Emerson, Carnegie, and Betker were our philosophers. And thanks to the genius of Carnegie's theory of human relations, many customers also became friends.
I don't consider high-pressure sales sales at all. It's a form of fraud. In true sales, you're providing a real and constructive service, helping people make their lives more agreeable or their companies more efficient. And in so doing, creating wonderful economies of scale from which everyone and the whole economy benefit.
The classic literature of self-improvement really was improving.
Here's something really good. It's Bedford quoting George Matthew Adams. The wisest and best salesman is always one who bluntly tells the truth about his article. That is always impressive. And if he does not sell the first time, he leaves a trail of trust behind. Being bluntly honest is always safe and best.
Other books, magazines, and audio tapes mixed practical tips with home truths.
Try this. Each time you handle a paper, mark it with a red dot. If you later encounter papers with three or four dots, you could be working more efficiently. Try to dispose of each paper the first time you handle it.
The enthusiastic, unsophisticated tone of much of this literature did open it up to the facile ridicule of halfwits.
Maybe I could use some of the same self-motivational techniques you use in sales in my Navy career. Every day, in every way, I'm becoming a better and better lieutenant junior grade. Every day.
What you're referring to is auto-suggestion, popularized by Quay during the 20s, but totally unserious. What I'm talking about has nothing to do with that. I loved coming into the office early and catching up on the overnight telex traffic. The telex line was our umbilical cord to Chicago.
Hi.
And confirmations for the bigger sales came through it, too.
What's wrong?
The Dickie Taylor is going to be supervising sales.
The Dickie Taylor of marketing.
I can't believe it. Work for that guy? I'm sure he's going to get me fired.
No, you're the best they have. They cannot do that.